Ari Height is live in West Palm Beach to explain her story. Ari?
And it was at this stretch right here of I-95 here in West Palm Beach where George Barahonas was found 1 year ago tomorrow with his two adoptive children. One was dead, the other was dying. And like you mentioned, there's a local woman who's on a crusade right now to make sure those children are never forgotten.
It was February 14th, 2011, when George Barahona's pickup truck was found on the side of I-95 in West Palm Beach. Barahona on the ground next to the truck, his adopted 10-year-old son in the passenger seat, barely alive, drenched in chemicals, and the boy's 10-year-old twin sister, Nubia Barahonas, in the back of the truck, dead, partially decomposed. Over the next few days, prosecutors released details of the horrific abuse they say the children suffered, tied up in a bathtub for days and weeks, beaten constantly by their adoptive parents. And down the road in Wellington, Kathy Cassell was watching the news coverage, sick to her stomach.
It was scary. It was, you know, it's just unbelievable. The torture and the torment that the kids went through.
Cassell felt compelled to do something, anything. So she started a Facebook page, Justice for Nubia. She posts links and updates to the page whenever she gets them. Now, almost 1,500 people follow Justice for Nubia.
It was kind of like getting people aware of child abuse cases and how many there were.
And now, almost a year later, Justice for Nubia is still going strong, as is Karen Cassell's desire to see tangible justice for Nubia in the form of guilty verdicts for George and Carmen Barahona.
It's mind-boggling how these two people have tormented, tortured, and horribly affected the lives of all these little kids.
And the 10-year-old boy who was found here along I-95, he is recovering, now living with a foster family. Both George and Carmen Barahonas have pleaded not guilty to murder and child abuse charges. We're live tonight in West Palm Beach. Ari Height, WPBF 25 News.